Hello and welcome you all again for the next part of the mass transfer operations. It's on extraction part 3. In this unit, in this particular part video, we'll look into different equipments that are used for extraction. All are related to the multi-stage extraction. So we'll be looking into three main types, commonly used ones: mixer settler, spray tower extractor, rotating disc contactor. Or the RDC extractor contactor. The industrial scale extractors, usually we use multi-stage countercurrent extraction for improving the recovery as well as efficiency of the process. Usually this flow arrangement, the movement of the liquids inside the extractors, they are induced by the hydrodynamic force, the driving forces, that is the flow, the pressure driven forces. Then the phase are separated. It's for the mixing. First thing is mixing. The second thing is separation. So the separation occurs based on either gravity or centrifugal force. So gravity is by density, it separates into two layers, or centrifugal action you can use for separating the thing. Now the which type of contactor you choose, it depends upon several criteria. Usually some like type of the chemical that you use there, the stability of that, whether the products are of high value, and the rate at which the phase gets separated. So usually there are two types. The classification, if you do it, it's two types. One is stage wise contactor, where the equipments what we have used, it includes series of physical stages in which the phases are mixed and separated. Whereas in the differential contactor, inside the equipment, the two phases are brought in contact and completely the phase separation takes only at the exit. What it means is, here you have separate components in the equipment where it mixes separate continuously, whereas in this one it continuously gets mixed up only at the end, only when it gets exit, only at the end phase it has got a separation process. So the equipments under stage wise contactor, the examples are mixer settler, baffle plate columns, usually they are titled like that. You can call it as a rotating disc contactor or RDC. Under differential contactors, you come across packed columns or even spray tower extractors. Let us look into the first one, mixer settler. As the name says, you have a mixing unit, you have a settling unit. In the mixing unit, you have an agitation, an agitator is present, baffles are present. The use of this agitator is to mix the liquid. You are going to feed the feed solution, and over that you are going to put the solvent. Both you are going to put it into this. If you just leave it like that, it separates into two layers. That should not happen. Mass transfer should take place. For that, you use agitator. So agitator is used to mix the entire quantity, and usually one equilibrium stage is achieved inside this. Only one equilibrium stage is achieved in one mixer. And you are going to mix it for a given amount of time, maybe 10 minutes mixing, 20 minutes mixing, or 1 hour mixing. That's called as hold up time. For a given amount of time it is mixed, that's called as hold up time. In that, it is expected to achieve one equilibrium stage. Now if you use the baffle, that increases the turbulence and the shear forces acting on the particles or the solvent globules, that will break the entire globule into fine particles. The finer particles, when they are produced, what happens is the surface area of interaction between the two different types of the solvent increases. So if the surface area increases, obviously mass transfer increases. The mass transfer is nothing but the solute from the one particular phase, that is a feed solvent to extracting solvent, it takes place. That the significant improvement in efficiency can be achieved when you have lesser surface area. But another problem with the droplet size, if the droplet size what you have there, if it is too low, it will be difficult in the next stage, where the entire mixture is sent to the settler unit, where it separates into two layer. In the settler it separates into two layer based on the density. You can use a gravity settler. So based on the gravity, based on the density, through the gravity, the lighter liquid will be on the top, usually extract. The heavier liquid, maybe a raffinate, settles at the bottom. If it is got very small droplets over here, the settling time will be very large. If it is too large a droplet, mass transfer problem will encounter. Separation may not be proper, but settling will be fast. So it's very important to operate with the proper particle size or fluid size, droplet size. So the coalescence of this droplet is an important issue over here. So here you have the baffle arrangements are present here, so that it breaks up the two layers of the liquid, and you can separate these two liquid in the different into different units. You may end up with one more stage here, multiple stage. Maybe this raffinate is fed to the next stage and this extract is taken. You can have a cross current operation, or you can have a counter current operation. That's multi-stage operation you can include, but this whole thing acts as one stage, one unit. So here is a video representing how it works. Okay, the video is from the Turbulent Technologies mixing system, TBTTT mixing system. So they have employed two different types of the turbine. They have used it one type of turbine, conventional agitator. They have used it here. So the drop size, you can see the droplet size, the size distribution, it's not uniform, uneven size and not uniformly distributed. So this is the mixer unit, and what they have done is they have installed another novel design. They have just removed that particular agitator. They have introduced, this is the baffle there, and just lifting it off. Alright, so the novel type of the agitator they have used, not a single blade, multi-bladed agitator they have used. So they want to analyze the performance, how the comparison, so the feed enters, mixes, see the, in the, this particular case, the droplet size is uniform and uniformly distributed and of the uniform size. So they could identify proper improvement in the mixing. This is the settler part. So you can see that in the case of settler with the modified one. Okay, this is how. So in the conventional case, you require larger size, larger length. Here they required lower size of the settler, reduce the size of the settler. So that's an advantage with their particular system. But you need to see how it worked out. Okay, you have another combination here. You can have a combined mixer settler, where the mixer settler is directly combined with the mixer, is combined directly with the settler, this type. So this increases the recirculation. The advantages are there as well as disadvantages are there. In the combined this particular part, if you raise it, there will be recirculation within that. This level should be equivalent equal to this particular flow path. That is called as a draught tube. Otherwise, there will be a recirculation within this. There won't be much movement on this. This is one modern design or modified design, quite commonly used. It is the integrated design. The second type, rotating disc contactor. Now, in this you have one cylindrical column in which you have an agitator. The agitator is multi-bladed. You can see here, this agitator, it is having one blade. Okay, this is called as rotor connected to the shaft. On the shaft, there are multiple rotors, rotor number 1, 2, 3, like that. There are multiple rotors. Across the rotor, there is something, a ring shape like this, called as stator. They are static, fixed to the wall of the cylinder. So something looks like this. The shaft rotates, you have a chamber created. Within this chamber, the liquid moves. Within the column wall, within the stator, the rotor is making the liquid to move like this. So this is continuously moving. Now the liquid enters. How? The heavy phase liquid enters, the light phase liquid enters here. Now heavy phase and light phase are, they need not there. This is either, these two are either feed solvent, feed in fact, feed solution or extracting solvent. One among these is entering here. Based on its density, it is termed as heavy and light. Among the two liquids, liquid solutions, whichever is having higher density, call it as heavier phase. Whichever is having lower density, call it as light phase. It could be the solvent being solvent used for extraction, or it could be feed solution, anything. The idea is heavy liquid, obviously because of its density, should move downward. And at the same time, light liquid, because of its density, it should move up. and there will be a counter current movement across heavy liquid and light liquid. Light liquid will be moving up because of density, heavy liquid moving downward because of density. Now here you have the rotors and stator assembly, and that ensures that there is a good amount of mixing and droplet size redistribution. So because of that, mass transfer increases. By the time this heavy liquid reaches bottom, where it comes out and leaves the extractor, whereas the light phase, it moves up and it is above this level. Note this light phase out is above, well above this level, otherwise the heavy phase will go out. So the lighter liquid will separate out over here. In this region there is a separation, so that separates out and goes out. So this is the principle with which it works. So this is the movement, a particle that comes in, maybe a heavy liquid, it comes randomly moves, or heavy liquid, light liquid, it comes and randomly moves. There is a random movement between the rotors and stators. Now here is a video. See this beam, this particular beam. Status. Alright, the next type, spray tower extractor. As the name says, you have one tower, that's column, in which the liquid is sprayed and the extraction takes place within the extractor. Now this is unagitated type, there is no agitator involved in this type, and it's a differential contactor. The previous two types are not different, those are the other examples. So here it is a differential contactor, different type. Now in this extractor there are two designs. Let us see one of them first. Two phases are flowing in countercurrent fashion. Heavier liquid, as I told you earlier, heavier and liquid, based on the density they are named. So it enters from the top, a lighter liquid enters from the bottom. Heavier liquid moves downward and exits here. Lighter liquid moves from the bottom and exits from the top. Now when you introduce this heavy liquid or lighter liquid, there is one particular way it is being allowed to get in. The lighter liquid is made to flow in like a bubble through a fine orifice. Through this orifice, this particular chambers, it is allowed to flow in. That is, you'll be using a nozzle or the orifice, or less orifice. So the lighter liquid is dispersed like a droplet. Fine droplets are dispersed, whereas the heavy liquid is just allowed to flow through that openings. Distributor, it is called as a distributor, whereas here you have a nozzle. This is type 1. Light liquid moves up through the nozzle. Nozzle is provided for the light liquid. Heavier liquid flows through the distributor. This is called as a distributor. It's not a nozzle. There is no nozzle, perforated pins, you don't have it. Type 2 is exactly the reverse of this. That is, you have here type 2. So the heavy liquid is sprayed using the nozzle, whereas in the type 1, the light liquid is sprayed using the nozzle. Here the light liquid just flows through the unit, flows through the unit from the bottom to the top of the unit. It flows out. Now multiple equilibriums are possible here. Multiple, at each stage you can have multiple equilibrium. So it is a multi-stage operation. One single unit you can use it for multiple stages. Yes, that is the end of this video. Summarizing, we have seen three different types of the equipment used for extraction, and we can use it as for single stage as well as multiple stage operations. Thank you.